Hi there, upholstery friends, and welcome to episode 73 of Kim's Upholstery Live, brought to you right here by Kim's Upholstery. Each week we share with you a different project that we're working on. Sometimes the projects take several weeks to complete, but we share the process with you step by step as you join us here live. So as you come in, we invite you to go ahead and share this live feed with your friends on your Facebook page. And we also invite you to like and follow our Kim's Upholstery page. And if you're watching on YouTube, go ahead and subscribe and hit that bell once you subscribe. And that'll give you notifications every time we do go live or add new video content to the YouTube channel. So again, thank you everybody for joining us today for episode 73. And we're continuing on this barrel back chair that we started a few weeks ago. Last week we finished getting the outside arms and outside back on, and we put in our sagless support system, which you see in here, and then we added padding to one of the inside arms, and that's as far as we got last week. So this week I'm hoping that we get to pad the rest of the inside back and arms and get all that fabric on, and maybe even get started on putting the decorative cord in the channel that we have that'll be left. So hopefully we'll get a little, you know, into that a little bit this week. But as you come in, go ahead and say hello. Let us know where you are viewing from. It's always fascinating to see how many different locations people come in from around the world to watch our live. So it's always fun to talk to different people from different areas. And if you're working on an upholstery project of your own and you have some questions, feel free to type your questions in the feed, whether you're on YouTube or Facebook. Type your questions and comments in the feed, and we'll get back to you and answer those if we don't get a chance to answer them to you actually live. We do try to answer them all live, but sometimes it goes a little fast and we might miss a couple. But I do go back through all the questions and comments later and respond to you if I didn't get a chance to do that during the live. So again, say hello, let us know you're here, and let's get started on this week's project. So I have a lot of questions from our members in the DIY group that we have here, both on Facebook and also the private community we have for members within the portal of the website, about a mirror image when you're doing one arm to the other arm when you've got a printed fabric. And this is a perfect example of a fabric that does not have a mirror image. It's not symmetrical, so the flowers are all going the same direction all the way across the fabric, and there are no areas where they head towards each other so that you can get a mirror image. So when we do these arms, you'll notice, let's see, you get the pins there, the pin in the center of what I wanted to be the main motif. But if you look, let me see if I can find it upside down. Right here are these little rosebuds. Now the ideal thing would be is if the other side of the fabric had the rosebuds on the opposite side. So that's what I mean by being able to get a mirror image. And 90% of the time I would say you cannot do that, unfortunately. It's just the way the fabrics are designed. I've always said that it would be nice if someone who was the end user of putting these fabrics to use would be the one that designed the fabrics, because I think the people designing the fabrics don't take that into consideration. So you do end up having everything going to the left or everything going to the right. There is not a mirror image typically. So I have put pins in what is the center of the motif, and that's the main part that I want to concentrate on to locate in the arm. Now it's not necessarily going to be center. I'm bumping the mic. It's not necessarily going to be in the center of the arm, but it's the motif that I want to be the most pleasing to the eye. So it doesn't necessarily, like I said, mean that I'm going to center that motif right in the exact number measurement center, because this arm is higher on the back side and shallower on the front. So I just want it to be pleasing to the eye. And your eye may be different than mine, so what looks good to me may be a little bit off to you. You may like it in a different location, and that really is the design of the person doing it, of where you want it located. And I've also marked the top of my fabric, because when you're getting to this point, it's easy with some of these prints to flip them upside down and not realize it. So I always mark the top so that I know that I've got it at the right position in the piece of furniture or whatever I'm working on. So let's take a quick look and see who's hopping in already this morning or this afternoon. Hello, Barbara. Thanks for joining us. Hey, Stacy and Rhonda. And we've got Donna. And Barbara says, oops, hi, Bill. Rhonda says, good morning. I'm watching from Castle Rock, Colorado. We've got Bonnie who has joined us, and Kirk. going by quick here. And Kevin has joined in, and Kevin says, hey, good day. How are the Nor'easters? We actually lucked out, Kevin. We're in the western part of Massachusetts, and we got like a smattering of snow, just like little sprinkle. Yeah, the driveway is, as soon as it hit the driveway, it melted. But I just talked to my friend this morning who is out in the eastern part of the state, and they got 2 feet of snow. So we lucked out with that. And hello, Donna. She says, hi, all. I'm home resting today. So that's it for Facebook, and let's see if there's anybody on YouTube. Has anybody come in yet? We have a few people in on YouTube as well.
Just Kim Broom
has joined us. So hello, Kim. Thanks for joining us. So let's get going on this. Let me get my staple gun around here. Now I'm using a pneumatic long nose staple gun. I think you probably all know by now that the long nose is my preference. I do have the short noses, but when you're using, or not using, when you're working in a piece like this, and I'm just trying to untangle my hose, working on a piece like this where you've got that groove that you've got to staple into, a long nose is much better than a short nose because it's not as thick, so it will go in the channel that's in the chair. All right, this is not going to come untangled that way, so let's do it the right way. I was using it this morning and it wasn't tangled, and I left the room and I swear it ties itself up. If you work with hoses, you know that too. I mean, there's never an easy way to keep these things from spinning around themselves. All right. So I'm gonna just play around with the positioning, get it where I like the looks of how the floral lands. And I did pick the same floral motif for both arms, but the inside back, I've chosen a different one that's a little bit larger. So I think I'm liking that left to right and up to down. All right, so let's go ahead and get a couple staples near the bottom here. I want to make sure that I'm in that channel. Let's go to the other side, get some in there. And you notice that I'm pushing on the top of the gun with my hand, and that's so that I can make sure I'm in that channel as deep as I can go. All right, so now I'm just going to pull straight up. And by the time you get all these layers of fabric in here, these channels do get pretty tight. Because we've got, you figure, we've got the outside arm fabric, we've got the sagless, and now we're putting the inside fabric in. And then we've still got to put a cording, which will go in here. Try to keep my padding behind the grooves here. And I'm watching the grain of the fabric as I go, trying to keep it straight. Some fabrics are more forgiving than others if you're a little off. This one actually has kind of a little strié appearance in the back of the background of the fabric print. You can see I'm not doing a lot of tugging. I'm just kind of smoothing the fabric out, keeping it taut from staple to staple, though.
You're aiming your staples so they don't come out on the wrong side.
Yes, and I am aiming my staples so they don't come out on the wrong side. Let me just double check. But yeah, I've got it aimed. And at this point, too, it's really hard to angle your staple gun the way you need it to sometimes. So you just really want to be conscientious that you're not shooting the staples in a manner that they actually come out through the decorative wood on the back side of the chair. It does happen. Then you have to patch a little spot. So like right here on the front, this channel is like really tight at this point. There's hardly any width to get into. And if you remember, if you've been watching the other episodes of this, this was a caned chair originally. So the arms anywhere were caned. The back was upholstered before. All right, so that looks nice and tight left to right. I can go ahead and move those pins. I don't need those in there anymore because now is at the point where I'd probably smooth the fabric and stab myself. And then we'd have blood added to the red flowers. Thank you. So you can see once you get to this point, it really does go pretty quickly attaching the fabric. Just making sure that padding is staying where I want. Okay, I have one staple there that I need to try and remove. Let's see if we can do this without tearing the fabric. And I'm using my bent awl to get that out. It just caused a pucker when I put the staple in, so I wanted to fix it now. There we go. And of course, being round, this chair does want to wiggle on you. So you have to be careful of it not shifting too much and making you do something you don't want to do. So what kind of projects are all of you working on out there? Let's see, I'm actually gonna put my knee up here to hold that from sliding so much. I've got a chaise to do here. It's partly done, it's torn down, the repairs are done. And it's time for spring tying. So I'm just, the whole time I'm watching what the fabric's doing as I go here. There, so I've gotten all the way to that top corner and everything is nice and tight. There's no slack in the fabric. I'm gonna go ahead and come out here. And depending on whether you're left-handed or right-handed, depends on one arm will be easier for you than the other arm. So as I'm going ahead and working on here, I also want to remind you to go ahead and hit that share button for us, if you would, and share this video episode out on your social medias. And we also, I'm getting pretty excited. We've been working on the behind the scenes for our High Point adventure that we've got coming up in July. I know you can't hear me when I staple. So we've got that coming up in July where we're doing our upholstery meetup with a bunch of our members. And I'm working on some different ideas, starting to scope out some more of the places that we might want to go see. And I'm getting really excited of all the things that I'm finding. All the things that I'm finding for different locations and stuff. So I'm really excited about it. And Greenhouse is hosting us for lunch on one day. So that'll be fun as well. And they're actually going to take us through the whole building and show us the whole processing of when you order your fabric, what the steps it goes through before it's shipped to you and everything. So it'll be neat to see how they do everything. And if you've ever worked with Greenhouse Fabrics or gone on their website and their YouTube channel, they have such a fun, playful group and they have some cute videos out there. So you should go check those out. And we've been chatting about it in our Kim's Upholstery DIY Hangout group, which is right here on Facebook, and you can find that in the left-hand side. You'll see where it posts our videos and stuff. It also posts that link to the group as well, so you can ask to join that. We have some really great in-depth conversations and a lot of fun in that group. And we also have an offer other people our other educational content, rather, by other industry experts, such as Sandra Van Sickle from Live with Sandra V. And Donna Cash, who is Designs by Donna in Atlanta. And then Jan Newton from Newton's Custom Interiors. So they have video content on our website for sale, which has, there's drapes, bedding, bed skirts, pillows, pillions, and cornice boards. And soon to be a Roman shade and another pillow is coming. And a bolster pillow is on there too. All right, so now you can see I've got this whole section done here. I got the back corner done, and all I have left to do is that bottom front corner, and it's looking really good. Just try trying to get myself situated. I'm going to check again, make sure I haven't gone off. So what I'm just doing is running my fingers, whoops, as I knock my chair off the pedestal. I'm running my fingers along the decorative wood to make sure none of the staples have poked out and we're all good. Put my jute webbing back under my leg to keep it from wobbling too much. So has anybody shared what they're working on with us, Bill? Few more staples, and this side will be done. Well, not done, because we still have to trim it and add the cording.
Well, there's quite a few comments.
So let me stop and take a look at your comments or questions. Hey, Amy, thanks for joining us. And Bonnie says, holy, we are still getting snow, 2 full days of it. Yuck. I'm ready for spring. I don't know about you guys. Hello, Deanna, and hello, Katrina. Thanks for coming over. Amy says, amen. The swivel we tried always allowed the air to leak.
Yeah, that's the piece you put on the gun, and it does.
Yeah, and it does. It leaks. Hello, Tony from Los Angeles. Thanks for joining us. Hello, Debbie and Sandra. And so, Sandra, if you want to go ahead and put a link to your class in here in the feed that I just mentioned, go ahead and you can do that. Andrew from San Diego, must be sunny in California. And Deanna says, yay, it's Wednesday live. I have to restaple the back of the barrel chair I did last year because the fabric choice satin pulled away from the edges when my big burly husband sat in the chair. I'm hoping it was just the corner that I didn't put. I can't see the whole question, so I didn't put the staples in tight enough, but I know. Sorry, guys, it's moving on me. Where was I? But I know the satin can be tough for the back. I did use fray check, but clearly there wasn't enough to prevent from pulling out through the staples. Yeah, there's certain fabrics that are just more difficult for pieces like that, and that's definitely one that I would categorize that way. And Bonnie says, hi, Sandra, she enjoyed your live last night. And Donna says she loved the live last night as well. Sandra reminds me I need to post pictures of my Claudine balance. And Deanna says my mohair chair was gorgeous. Thanks, Deanna. Bonnie says I'm starting to put the deck on a wing back for my amazing mom for her birthday. That's nice. Deanna says I'm working on an oversized chair with a T cushion, loose back cushions. I've seen the pictures, Deanna. It's going very well. Once my rest day is over, I'll be back making an indoor tent to go along with the window treatments for my lumberjack chick nursery outside of St. Louis. It's adorable so far. Embroidered with Beckham's little man cave. You'll have to share that with us, Donna. I can't wait to see that. I know the one you just posted recently of the two little girls' rooms you did were adorable. Donna's excited to go to High Point with us. Hello, Crystal. Thanks for joining. And Joanne says, hi from Jacksonville, Florida. She's also working on a wingback chair. Peggy says she's here from Virginia. She came in late. That's okay, Peggy. It's recorded. You didn't miss too much, but you can always go back. Kevin said he just finished a headboard for a client, and we'll discuss it in this afternoon's meeting. Okay, so you're going to be in the live Q&A, I'm assuming. Nancy says, wingback chair, but the decking drives me crazy. Yeah, decking is one of those things that it takes a while to get the knack of. So that looks like it's it for comments right now. So let's go ahead and get back to the next side.
Well, I wanted to put up, since we were talking about the Wednesday Live.
Okay, so Bill's...
Just put a picture up so that people can see what it looks like.
So Bill's going to share some images with you from our live. So if you see on that Q&A, that's actually Joanne sitting in the middle. And you can see at the bottom the faces. And those are all the people that are actually in live with us. So we actually go in. It's in our member portal, and they come right in live. We share questions, and you can show us, you know, move your camera over to show the project you're working on. And we do have a really great time. Sometimes we get a little off topic and have way too much fun, but, you know, that's how the conversations go. So we do that at 3 o'clock on Wednesdays after we've done the live with the public here. Oops, I got one staple that kicked back at me. Let me go ahead and rock that out of there. Perfect. Okay, now I'm just kind of, oops, there's a couple spots down here that I missed putting staples in. So let me hide inside the chair for a moment and do that. Can you tell I really get into my work? Definite pun intended. Before I trim this, what I'll do too is go around and make sure I've got it attached everywhere. That's pretty good. I probably will end up adding a couple more here and there, but we are at a point where we can go ahead and flip it over and do the next section. So I think what I'm going to do is do the inside back next and go ahead and just pin this out of my way for now. And I did trim everything from last week. I had left all the stuff there, and I did end up trimming the fabric back off camera just because I figured it would be easier to do what we needed to do here today. So I'm going to go ahead and roll this onto its back. So for the inside back, for the arms, what I did, and I actually wrote myself notes here so I'd remember what I used for padding. I suggest you do that when you're working on a project and then you stop and go away, because the worst thing in the world is getting your second arm upholstered and finding out the thicknesses aren't quite the same. So on the inside arms, I've written right here that I used 2 layers of cotton and 1 layer of Dacron. The back, I want it to be a little poofier, so I think I'm going to go with 3 layers of cotton on the back and then 1 Dacron. But like I said, the arms you want to be identical, so you better have to make yourself notes, because I don't know about you, I come back in the next day and I'm like, okay, what did I put on there? I don't remember. So just write it right on the furniture, and that way you don't lose it. So let me grab a couple pieces of cotton over here. And cotton sometimes is not consistent through the roll too, so you may end up having to adjust according to that as well. Most often it's fairly consistent, but every once in a while, the way it comes off the roll, it's not quite the same thickness every time. These little whiskers. Get our next piece. So that's layer number 1. And again, I'm keeping it so that it won't go into the channel. All right, now let's get the second layer. And actually, you know what? I think I might actually put, I can tell by the feel, I'm going to put a small layer down the center to build up the center of this. But I don't want a cut edge because it'll cause a ridge. So let's just tear that off. Come on. Yes, I'm just feathering those edges out. All right, and I'm still going to want 3 full layers, but I just wanted to add that little bit of extra in the center because I could tell it's quite hollow because of the shape. Come over here and grab another roll. And I just tear it off and estimate the size. I don't bother measuring and having, you know, taking a tape measure and doing all that. I just kind of tear them off. And I use my other hand to keep it from tearing back where I don't want it to tear. Okay, so that's 2 plus that center piece. And yeah, I definitely think I want that third one. So I'm going to go ahead and put the third one on, and then we'll be ready for our Dacron. Get another piece over here. So here is piece number three. Been having a lot of fun doing our member interviews too, and I know I reached out to a few more of you this week that have agreed to do it, so we got some more coming up, and it's fun to hear everybody's stories and to share, help them share their business and get their name out there for clients, prospective clients looking for upholsterers in their area. All right, so now let me grab a piece of Dacron. And this I am going to go ahead and cut with scissors because you can't tear Dacron like you can cotton. So I'm just going to kind of get it in position and then I will trim it down. First, I'm going to go ahead and trim it at the top. My scissors are never happy when I make them cut Dacron. All right, so now we slimmed it down a bit at the top. I might even need to go a little bit more. Let's check the sides first. And I can feel that my scissors are up against the edge of the cotton, so I'm not cutting completely blind here. Be careful not to cut my deck. You don't want to have to redo the deck at this point. All right, so I think I'm going to get a couple staples here and there just to hold this before I cut the next side and trim down the top if I need to. Now again, this is where I've got to really be careful because I'm stapling into the top of the decorative wood and I want to make sure I angle it so that it doesn't come out on the face side on the back. And I don't want my padding in the channel, the groove that I'm stapling the fabric in. Before I go too far, let me make sure I didn't come out where I don't want to. So far, so good. All right, so we got along there. This way. So how many of you have ever been to High Point before? And if so, do you have any suggestions of great places that you found to be interesting and fun to go visit?
I
want to
know where you're going to eat
with Carly's. Yeah, actually, when I go to Chauvin, Louisiana, I want to go start checking out the restaurants online. I'm not a hot, spicy food person, so I may be like eating salads the whole time. But I am into seafood, and Carly tells me there's lots of seafood. And it's fresh. It's what?
This is at the workshop.
Yeah, Carly from Carly's Customs is hosting a workshop in April that's already sold out. And I think some of you, I think there's somebody that's online now watching that was going to that workshop. But the food I've been told is going to be really yummy and the freshest seafood I've ever had. And I love photography. That's my other hobby. I actually have a degree in portrait photography. And so when I get down there, I am like dying to get some pictures of the alligators. And Bill's like, don't let her get too close to the alligators because I'll be focusing on the camera and the other one will come up and bite me in the butt.
No stopping at the drive-through margarita place on the way.
That's right. And they tell me that there's a drive-through margarita place too. I can't fathom drive-through margaritas. It's just the funniest thing to me. But I'm looking forward to checking it all out. All right, so I'm pulling, I've got the Dacron attached down there really well, so I'm pulling it really taut. And I'm going to go ahead and get a couple staples in here, and then we'll come back and trim it. But I'm pulling in the center first. So I want it nice and tight. And this is also one of those times when it'd be easy to staple your fingers, because if you look at what I'm doing, I'm pulling it, but I'm also angling the gun towards me when I staple, and I have to slide my fingers out of the way just before I fire that staple. That's where you get everything in position, and then you slip just as you pull the trigger. Oops, that one went right through. Now, the back of this chair was tufted before, but I really didn't like the tufting. It was just, to me, I'm not one of these people that likes those little tiny, tiny diamonds. And that's about all you could do with this chair, because I played around to see if I could do a bigger design and make it look good, and I just couldn't find anything that I liked size-wise, so I opted to not tuft it this time. Which tufting is pretty, but I'm not one that likes a lot of tufted furniture. And that's just my taste. I'm more French country and shabby chic. And lots of pink. Right, Bill?
Yep.
If Bill had his way, our house would be all airplane motif with, like, literally parts of airplanes. Because that's his hobby. So you can see I'm just keeping this Dacron really nice and taut from front to back as I go. And now we'll go ahead and start working on the sides. I'm going to go one more closer to the corner over here. And maybe one more over here. All right, so before I actually just double check myself. Phew, no staples coming out. It's bound to happen to you at least once, or twice, or three times. It's one of those things. Everybody does it once. And just when you think, oh, I'm in a good spot, I'm doing them all great, you just get carried away and start going along, and that's usually when you end up coming out. Now, speaking of Chauvin, we also have our workshops coming up this fall. Rhonda, who is actually right here, she owns the Whimsical Chair in Castle Rock, Colorado, and she's hosting a workshop in September, which we have four spots left. And then we have one in Lakeland, Florida, and that one has three spots left. That's in October. And then there is one in Galax, Virginia, which is in November. We have five spots left in that one. And I'm already starting to work on dates for 2019. So if there's anybody out there viewing that's interested in hosting a workshop for 2019, shoot me an email. You can just shoot it at info@kimsupholstery.com and let me know, and I'll send you the information on that. They're fun. We have a good time in the three-day workshops. We do the upholstery workshops, the three-day small chair. We also do one-day ottoman classes, and then we do the two-day slipcover classes. And we do some advanced upholstery classes as well. But everybody brings their own chair. It's already torn down when you get to class. And we just start putting them all back together. Okay, keep checking behind the chair as I go. I'm bound to get one that comes through. So I keep checking because I want to take it out before I get to the next layer. And then it's hidden underneath fabric. So far, so good. How many of you have stapled pieces and had the staples show in the decorative wood and you didn't realize it till everything was done? It's got to have happened to somebody. That's how we learn, right? We learn by the little mistakes that we make along the way. It's part of the process. All right, so now I'm ready to go ahead and trim down the second side and get that stapled, and then we're ready for fabric on the inside back. try not to cut this other fabric. Here we go. Just kind of peeking behind it to make sure my scissors aren't going into the arm and cutting that, because that would not be fun. Now that that's all attached. Oops, I almost dropped my scissors. Let's go ahead and trim this over right here. And sometimes your channel is big enough that you can actually ride the other side of your scissors in it. At this particular chair on the top, I can ride it in a little bit, but on those sides, there's not a lot of room. What the heck? I'm trying to cut a staple or something. Let me see here. There we go. I think it was hooked on the sagless underneath. Okay, so now we're ready to go ahead and staple this edge. Sorry for the phone sounds. Okay, so far so good. I know it's hard for you to see that channel on camera here, but it's right outside of my staple gun. All right, so far so good. No staples have come through. I'm going to jinx myself. You know, on the last arm, I'm going to get them all coming out. Almost at the bottom. This is an awkward position this time to get the gun in there and get my body in the right position with the chair. All right, now let's check one last time. All the way around, make sure I didn't miss any staples. So I'm just running my fingers along the decorative wood. And nothing, no staples hanging out. Yay! All right, now we are ready for fabric.
So, we've got quite a few comments and stuff.
Okay. All right, so let me go ahead and catch up on the comments here. Retha says, I'm getting started. Oh, there we go. Tony says, it's sunny today, but it's been raining. Sherry says, I'm working on a chair almost exactly the same as this. However, it has a metal rod instead of a wood at the base. So I'm a bit of a loss as to how to make the cotton wool. Make the cotton so it doesn't move.
She can join the group and ask that.
Actually, we just had a member doing that in the group. So if you go in the Kim's DIY Upholstery Hangout right here on Facebook and ask to come in there, you can see the conversation and we'll help you out with that if you want to post pictures in there. So Joanne says, my staple gun keeps misfiring. What do I do to fix this? Bill?
She says misfeeding.
Oh, misfeeding. I'm sorry, misfeeding.
Misfeeding or misfiring, I really don't know. Normally, it's a pressure problem or your gun just needs a cleaning. So after you shoot a lot of staples, sometimes you just get a plastic residue that coats the chamber.
Yeah.
And it's just because of the staples going through. So I usually take a wire brush and try to clean that out, and then I add a little bit of silicone spray.
So where you're talking about, Bill, is this area right here in the front, right? You're on this camera, right?
And the actual, yeah.
Yeah, so I'm not sure which camera you've got up there. So he tries to do this area right in here. Whoops. So it's this area right in here, Joanne, that he cleans with a wire brush, and in here as well. Because I know sometimes mine start to get stuck. And also this part, you probably can't see it on camera, but when you pull the air, this thing shoots up that pushes the staples out. And sometimes that will not go all the way back down if that channel's not clear. It'll get sticky.
So it could be pressure. And also you want to make sure that your staples are good, because we had a whole box of staples one time that were a little bit bent, and towards the end of the row of staples, we always had a problem. And we determined that it was actually the staples.
It was actually the box of staples, yeah. They had probably been like banged so that it like squished one end of the whole box, and they just weren't, they were misfiring. So try a couple different things. See if the pressure on your air compressor is set right. Clean out those areas with a wire brush just to get any gunk that's built up in there. And then if it still has the problem, try a different box of staples and see if that solves it. So, okay, so here is the back. Oops, I got some more comments, sorry. Rhonda says, I'm working on the mid-century chair. I tore it down yesterday. I found a lovely woodworker to do the wood repair for me. I'm sure he's not as amazing as Bill. You never know, he might be. And Donna is saying, Rhonda, I can't wait to see what you do with that chair. And if I'm remembering correctly, that's the one that had the tufted cushion in it. That was pretty cool. Rhonda says, I wish I was coming on the trip this summer. I have two boys that start school the 1st of August. Maybe I can make the next trip. Definitely. And if you get locations you'd like to go on a second trip, let me know. And Barbara says, me too, Rhonda. Sandra says, thank you, Kim, for allowing me to post the link to my Roman Shade class. So there's her Roman Shade class right there. And then Sandra says, thanks, Donna and Bonnie. I had a blast last night, too. Donna said, Sandra, I was cooking dinner while watching. I think Michael thought I was watching a cooking show when he walked in. And then Bonnie says, Sandra, you and Ken always make me smile when I watch you two. I know, they are funny together. And Kevin says, the golden oldies.
He must be talking about Ken.
He must be talking about Ken. But back to Rhonda's comment on the mid-century modern, it's too bad that I'm not in the market for pieces, because there's a friend of mine in this area whose brother-in-law has a house that he's trying to get rid of all the stuff, and he was trying to give me a bunch of mid-century modern furniture the other day, and I just don't have a place for it. Jackie says, hi, yes, there is a drive-through in Louisiana, laugh out loud. Yeah, that just blows my mind that you have drive-through margarita restaurants. It's like driving through Dunkin' Donuts for coffee. Is this your chair or a customer's, Barbara asks. Well, it's mine, but it's for sale. You want it? I picked this up at an auction, I think, several years ago, and I'm finally getting around to doing it. Sandra says, I just saw a few antique places in High Point when I was there last week. I was on a time crunch, so I could not stop in. There's a great sewing machine shop. He sells everything from huge scissors, machines, and foam cutters. Well, we'll definitely have to put that one on the list, Sandra.
We're doing a live get-together just on High Point.
Yeah, we're going to be doing a live Zoom together within the Kim's DIY Upholstery Hangout group here on Facebook talking about High Point. So I'd love to have you come in and share some of that information with us there. And hello, Kathy. I haven't seen you in a long time. I hope all's well with you. What size staples are you using? Retha is asking. So I'm using 3/8 inch staples, and I also have my 9/16, which I'm thinking I had thought I would need to switch to, but these are going in deep enough that I'm okay with the 3/8 inch. With the 9/16, when I'm angling it, doing the stuff on top, those would be when it would probably come out the other side. Where do you purchase the cotton and Dacron from? I get all my supplies from Albany Foam and Supply out of Albany, New York. Sandra says, this is funny, Donna and Bonnie. We love having you joining us each week. Katrina says, need new one rings.
New
O-rings. Okay.
It's possible.
That is possible. Yeah, we've had to change those. Let's see. Yes, and O-rings. I see where you changed it. Joanne says, okay, thanks. I will check all of the above. What pressure should it be at?
Ours is at 80.
Yeah, ours is about 80 that it's set at. But
two different brands of guns, and funny, it's a different setting for each gun.
Right. We have the Fasco and we have the TacWise. The TacWise guns like it better at 90, and the Fascos like it better at 80. So your gun can be a variation with that as well. So Betty says, love watching you do this. Thanks, Betty. Let's see. Rhonda says, you could use one of the mid-century modern chairs for a live class. But then what do I do with it after? But that would be good. Tell me when, just not today, Sandra says. Yeah, I know, you're like trying to pound out a bunch of Roman shades before midnight tonight. And hello, Annette. Thanks for joining us. So, all right, back to our inside back fabric. And again, I don't know if you can see it on camera. So go ahead and reminder, just please click that share button if you wouldn't mind helping us share this out there if you haven't already. But on the inside back here, I have also put an X, which is the center of my motif. So when I'm laying my pattern on here, it helps me positioning just like we did on that inside arm. And this print, so this is the largest motif, which was the main print in this fabric that I'm using for the inside back. But now that I've got it on the chair, even though that is the center of it, Are they on the top camera? Can you guys see those pins? I'm not sure if you can. So right there is what is actually the center of the print. But as I look at it on the chair, you can see this side here is quite beige, but this side over here has a pink rose. And to me, even though that is pretty centered left to right, this rose over here throws that off a little bit. And when I found the center of the print, what I did is I went to the outer perimeter of where the design is, which is right here where we've got some vines going on. And then I went to the outer perimeter, I think it was actually of this rose that I'm seeing. And so that's how I got my measurement for the center of the motif. And I did the same thing top to bottom where the motif print stopped and started into the next floral. But because of this pink over here, I think I need to actually shift this more to the left. And this is a good example of why you want to cut your fabric a little bit bigger than you need and not short yourself, because you get to the piece of furniture and sometimes what you thought was going to work turns out that it's not the best choice. So here you can see, if I scooch it over this way, and I'm not scooching it a lot, now that looks much more evenly spaced with the print around the chair. I've still got some white area over here, but then I've got some white area down here. It's not really white, but then I got some beige area down here in the bottom. So those kind of balance each other out and don't make it look so heavy to one side. So let me know if any of that made sense. Didn't make any sense at all. So now I'm looking top to bottom just to double check. And that I like. I've got the leaf coming down from the bottom of the motif, and then I've got the leaf from the motif above it coming into play here. So I like the rest of it. So I think that's, even though this is the center of my print, I think scooching it to the left a little bit and ignoring that makes a much better placement in the chair. So before I commit to it, I'm just going to come around and look at it from this side. Make sure that it looks as good as I think it does from upside down. And I think it does. So what do you guys? You guys like it, or do you think it looked better the other way? It's one of those design decisions. So if I turn, there, you can see it a little better. So I think we're going to commit and go for it. So again, I'm going to start at the bottom. And then I'll come up to the top. Oops, not step on my hose. Again, check to make sure my staples are not coming out, even though they're in the channel, you just never know. And at this point, it really is hard to feel the channel with all the other things going on. And I'm using both my hands and the nose of the stapler to smooth my fabric to where I need it. And it's hard not to have my arm in your way here. Top to bottom, if I go like this, I'm not getting any slack in the fabric, so I got it nice and tight. And now we'll go ahead and do left to right. Okay, and those didn't go in anywhere. So I'm really having to force this gun into the groove to make the staples go into wood. All right, now I'll go ahead and get some on the other side. One side, like I said, is always easier than the other. Whoops, and then your chair falls off the pedestal. Put another pin in that because it's flopping down. I think I lost my pin. Got some more comments and questions. OK, Okay, so Barb says, are your previous shows available on your Facebook or anywhere? Yes, Barb, they are. They're available both on Facebook and on YouTube. So if you go on the left-hand side of our page, you'll see a column that has the listings on the Facebook page, sorry, that has the about and stuff, and you'll see two different video categories. I'm not sure whether it's the top one or the bottom one. Bill says it's the top one. So click on that top one, and it should give you all of our Facebook Lives. Hello, Sherry. Thanks for joining us. And Tony said it made perfect sense. Yay! Do you always use upholstery fabric, or can you use a thicker fabric while doing this? I always use upholstery fabric. Some are thicker than others, so I'm not quite sure I understand your question.
Well, you just wouldn't use a thin fabric.
You wouldn't use a super thin fabric, or maybe you're talking about this particular chair. For this kind of a situation, a really thick fabric would not be the best option because those channels that I'm stapling into are very thin. Bonnie says, perfect description, great. Hello, Krista, thanks for joining us. Definitely better with the adjustment. Okay, so with the adjustment of the print, I forgot what that was a response to, sorry. The cushion also will take up height and then to match the cushion with the back. The cushion is actually being done out of the fabric we used for the outside back, so there's no pattern match on this piece. With the back, Katrina says, and then I guess that's it. Okay, all right, so back to stapling. Sometimes I forget what questions I ask when I go back to read your responses and I have to think for a second. Now you can hear the air sneaking out of there. Just checking to make sure they're not.
Yeah, Becky Wilkerson and Deb are watching on YouTube.
Hello, Becky and Deb on YouTube. Thanks for watching. Now we're also going to be adding another live segment. We're not quite sure what we're going to do yet, but if you guys have any ideas of specific things you're interested in seeing other than just projects, we'd love to hear your input.
Maybe they want to see you sing and dance.
Oh, you don't want to see me sing. I'll dance, but you don't want to see me sing. I dance all the time. I'm always dancing around the house. Bill just looks at me and shakes his head. He tells me I have too much energy. So far, no staples have come out. Holy cow, I thought at least, well, I shouldn't say that out loud. I'll be quiet now because I'll jinx myself. Oops, see, I stabbed myself with that pin. Let me put that pin in a different direction here. There. Sorry for the squeaky air hose, guys. And I drew blood. I hope nobody has a weak stomach. Let me get a Kleenex before I get it on the chair. Bill, would you want to get me a Band-Aid? It's not that bad, but I'm just afraid I'll get it on the fabric as we go here if I don't get it under control. That's one thing. If you ever watch any of my video tutorials, those of you that are members that are out here watching can attest to this. I start the video off with no Band-Aids, and by the end of the video, I usually have at least two or three. Yeah, if you're squeamish to blood, upholstery is not something you want to get into because you will be drawing your own blood all the time. Let me just get this on and I'll come back and finish stapling that. And I don't know if any of you are aware of this, but the best thing to get blood out of the fabric and stuff is if it's your blood, is your own saliva. So if you just lick your finger and wipe the spot where you get the blood, it usually gets the blood up really well. But you got to do it right away. Okay, so now we have that top. Now I'm going to go ahead and come over here and come to the top, and then we'll do those two bottom corners. We're going to be doing another channel back chair for our online classes soon as well. Okay, so let me start coming down. And I've got two staples here that didn't quite go in, so let me pop them out. Now, many of you on here watching today are members of our online classes, and you're also members of our Kim's DIY Upholstery Hangout. And I have to tell you guys, you make that group so awesome. It's really encouraging when, you know, we have it there to help everybody work on projects. And if Bill and I aren't available to chime right in, somebody is always jumping right in to help one another. And it's just such a great community and very supportive. We don't have any of those prickly mean comments. It's all nice stuff and encouraging each other. So you guys, I thank you for making it such an awesome group. So we've got a couple staples that were just like going into the air. For some reason that spot just does not want to hit any wood. Let's see. There, that's working. Let's check the decorative wood. So far, so good. Constantly running my hand behind the chair here. Sometimes doing some of these projects is like taking a yoga class. You have to contort your body into so many different positions to get where you need to be. All right, that looks like it's all held nice. Go ahead and do this last corner. There, we have staples everywhere. Yay! All right, now we'll go on to the arm. And there's the air compressor. All right, so I'm folding that back to get it out of the way for when I do this last arm. And we are actually almost at the bottom of the hour already. For those of you that are members of the online classes that we just talked about, we are going to be live doing our Q&A session this afternoon at about an hour or about 90 minutes from now, about an hour and a half, so it's 3 p.m. Eastern time. We encourage you to hop on over there early and get some of your questions in the chat. But as always, we ask you to come in live and be on camera, like the situation that the rest of you just saw. Everybody comes in and we have great conversation. We're usually on there from 3 to 4 o'clock. So we encourage you to come on over. You can join from your mobile device. You can take your cell phone, move it over and show us your project, or you can even move your laptop and use the camera to show us the project you're working on if you have specific questions that you need answered. Or just maybe come in and have some conversation even if you don't have questions. We love chatting with all of you. Go through the drive-through margarita place. There you go. So Bill says, I'll maybe have a cup of coffee or tea. No margaritas this afternoon, but... So we appreciate you guys all taking the time out of your days to join us here for our Kim's Upholstery Live. And we'd love it if you go ahead and share this with your friends. Go ahead and like it. If you like what we're doing and you want us to keep it up, give us a thumbs up or a smiley face. No angry faces, please. Unless I'm just not doing the project that you want me to do. But thanks again, everybody. I'm going to go ahead and get this last arm padded and get the fabric on so that next week we can start with either the cording or the cushion. We'll see which way we go first. But have a great rest of your week, everybody. And for you that are members, I'll see you on the inside very shortly. Thanks, everybody. I hope you enjoyed this video. I would really love to hear from you. What was your takeaway or aha moment? Now come on over to our website where we have great conversations about all things upholstery and share your takeaway from today's live with us. Become a member and let me help you feed your upholstery addiction. We also have our weekly live Q&A sessions with our members only where we enjoy spending time together and laughing about all things upholstery, and we even learn from one another as we share our ideas. And while you're here on YouTube, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and ring that bell that you see up in the top so that you can get notified of our upcoming episodes as we put them here on YouTube. We'll see you on the inside, and I'll catch you right back here next week. Brought to you by Kim's Upholstery, where we bring the training to you.